I saw a movie on the plane. I bought it last night in a thing called Defiance. I had not heard of the movie, but I saw Daniel Craig was on the DVD, and the young man said it's pretty good, it's action. I said I like action drama, so I took it with me on the plane and I watched it. Daniel Craig, Defiance, based on the incredible true story. And what's the true story? Daniel Craig, who played James Bond, stars as Tuvia Bileski, an ordinary citizen turned hero. In this action-packed epic of family honor, vengeance, and salvation, Defiance is a riveting adventure that showcases the extraordinary story, true story, of the Bileski brothers, simple farmers outnumbered and outgunned who turned a group of war refugees into powerful freedom fighters. Tuvia, along with his unyielding brother, Zeus, played by Liev Schreiber, who did a great job. I'm not a Liev Schreiber fan, but he did a great job. Anyway, they motivate hundreds of civilians to join their ranks against the Nazi regime. Now, if it was fiction, it would be not worth talking about. But it isn't fiction. It's about an actual pair of brothers in, I believe, Poland in 1940 who refused to be captured by the Nazis. They were Jews. But in this case, and here's the interesting part of the story, one of the brothers was a smuggler and a thief. And he was tough enough as a result to stand up to the murderers and become a murderer himself in order to save thousands of people who did not know how to kill. And the story that I am telling you has direct relevance to what we are living through here in America. We don't have tough men running America. We have calculating men. We have devious men. We have shrewd men. But none of them are tough enough for the times we are living in. None of them are tough enough to face the animals that would cut your throat, that would slash your daughter's throat in front of your eyes and throw it down a well. None of these men are tough enough for the job. Do you understand what I said to you? Well, let me go back to a more important story, which is the movie Daniel Craig, Defiance. So here are these two guys in Poland who don't want to lay down and die and beg the Nazis to let them live, their mothers and fathers and neighbors. And they did it one at a time, killing them, taking their guns, stealing farmers' food in order to survive. And they then protect the people who can't defend themselves, the old and the young. And they go off into the forest of Poland and live through horrendous times in the winter, living off the air itself. And they have to hook up with the Russian partisans in order to survive out there. But this guy, the important part of the story to me is the characters are real, number one. It's the Bileski brothers. These are the type of guys, hard as nails, hard as a rock. And Bileski, one of them was a smuggler, a criminal, in other words, a low-grade criminal, who had the guts to face off against the Nazis on their own terms, meaning become a murderer just like them. The intellectuals couldn't even hammer a nail in the forest in the winter. There's a very telling scene in the movie where they're trying to build shelter in the winter to get through the horrendous winters that are coming. And one of the intellectuals that they try to rescue can't even drive a nail. And he says to him, well, what did you do before the war? He said, nothing really. He said, what do you mean nothing? He said, I published. What did you publish? He said, I published a pamphlet. I was a pamphlet publisher. The guy couldn't even drive a nail. He couldn't cut a piece of wood. He couldn't build a shelter. They didn't shun him. They taught him how to drive a nail and how to saw a piece of wood and how to man a gun and kill somebody. They showed him how to do it. What I'm getting at is, Obama was once asked during the campaign what he actually did. And he actually said, I don't do anything. All I do is push paper. Obama is an intellectual, a paper pusher. Doesn't mean he's an evil man. I don't think Obama's evil at all. I don't think he's evil at all. I don't think he has an evil bone in his body. Let me tell you that right now. I look at the man and I see an ordinary guy who's pretty intelligent, who got pushed forward all his life by radical left-wing communists with millions of dollars from the time he could say Punahou. They picked him young. They picked him young. They schooled him. They schooled him and they groomed him. They never thought they'd get this far. And they are all over their head. Our only hope in this situation is that the American people themselves wake up before it is too late. And I primarily mean the Democrat, the mainstream Democrat, who will come to understand that a radical left-wing incompetent group of academic goons have taken over not only their party, but the security of their children and grandchildren.